Meet Toya. She's a doll created in London who speaks Jamaican Creole, known as Patois. She was created by an English teacher from Greenwich while on maternity leave.
I always said to myself, if I should have a daughter, I want her to have a doll that looks like her, especially for her own self-esteem.
When the BBC children's series Rasta Mouse was first aired, it sparked debate over its use of Jamaican Creole. Does Saffron fear her doll might also be criticised?
I know for a fact that there are some parents who are against it because they think that Jamaican Patois is actually broken English, and so they fear that their children's English will actually be distorted as a result. But the reality is, it is a language in its own right, and knowing another language definitely does not interfere with, you know, your main language at all.
We love with your chicken and rice and peas, but most of all, we love to party and have a good time.
Her dream was funded by her family, but she struggled to find a doll maker to take it on.
Some of the manufacturers are saying it is too expensive to produce black dolls because they're not in demand. So white dolls are in demand worldwide.
And I put that issue to the head of the association which represents toy companies in the UK.
Many large manufacturers are very much aware, so you will find dolls and indeed toys of all types which appeal to or try to reflect society. Maybe not as well as they might have done, they could have done, but it's certainly a coming trend.
And to feed that trend, Saffron's creating a wider range of Jamaican-inspired dolls. But so far, it's Toya who's the bestseller. Aisha Baksh, BBC London News.